Before I get into the content of today's episode, let me mention that I'll provide you with a comprehensive list of Edge driver information and channel links at the end of today's video. This information will be invaluable to you if you have installed a lot of custom device type handlers and you need to find Edge drivers to replicate the capabilities found in those custom device type handlers. So be sure to stay through the end of this video if this situation applies to you. Well, now SmartThings has released yet another update about the transition from legacy Groovy IDE platform to the SmartThings Edge environment. Most notably, they have moved the date for the shutdown of the Groovy IDE from October 15th now to December 31st, 2022. Quoting SmartThings, "Beginning September 30th, 2022, we will start migrating devices and smart apps from legacy Groovy technology to our new technology we call SmartThings Edge." They went on to say that they have been working diligently with their partners and user community to migrate devices, and they expect that the majority of supported devices will be fully migrated by December 31st, 2022. Now, I emphasize supported devices because I believe they're talking about the standard device type handlers, not to be confused with the custom device type handlers, which I'll discuss next. Continuing in the announcement, they gave a reminder which was directed to users that have installed custom device type handlers. They said that these device handlers, which you can find under the My Device Handlers tab in your Groovy IDE, users with these type of devices are urged to take action on these devices before December 2022 to prepare them for migration and to avoid any loss of features. Now, if you have little or no custom device type handlers, then you should not be overly concerned at this point because most of the standard device type handlers will be seamlessly migrated. But for those of you who need to migrate several custom device type handlers, the article provides 6 options for converting these devices to Edge. I'll leave a link to the SmartThings Q&A article in the description below this video if you'd like to review the provided options. I'll also provide a resource link to a list of custom Lua Edge drivers, which you can use to source available custom Edge drivers. SmartThings reported that there is no published schedule for when particular devices will be migrated, nor will you receive a notification that the migration has occurred. You can identify whether a device is using an Edge driver in your SmartThings app by opening the app and selecting the device. Then choose the More options in the upper right-hand corner of your app. If your device is Edge-enabled, the drop-down menu will list the word driver as an option. When you click on the driver link, you can review the driver information. The article goes on to state that the SmartThings Groovy IDE will begin losing some of its functionality beginning on October 15th, 2022. After this date, the IDE will no longer allow the creation or debugging of Groovy device type handlers and smart apps. SmartThings has stated that once they are confident that most users have had time to move away from legacy Groovy device type handlers and smart apps, they plan to depreciate most features in the SmartThings Groovy IDE. After full depreciation on December 31st, 2022, SmartThings may allow very limited functionality in the Groovy IDE if necessary, but will fully shut off the tool sometime early 2023. Now, if you need to access your SmartThings devices via a web browser after the termination of the Groovy IDE, SmartThings recommends using the SmartThings web at my.smartthings.com. A link is provided in the description below this video. To find news and information about custom Edge drivers and integrations, SmartThings recommends that you access the SmartThings community and the developer portal. I'll leave these links in the description for those resources as well. Based on the request of my subscribers and also for my own needs, I have accrued a significant list of Edge driver channels and information sources, which I will make available to you today in the description below. You'll find these links under the heading Edge Driver Resources. The first item in this list is a help guide that explains how to enroll in a shared driver channel and also provides instructions for installing the shared drivers. The next item is titled Quick Browse Links for Edge Drivers. This is a comprehensive list of Edge drivers put together by the community contributors to help users migrate devices with custom device handlers. In addition to these resources, I'll provide multiple driver information links as well as Edge driver channel links. Included in this list are drivers for AOTech, Dome, InnoValley, SmartThings, T-Austin's Virtual Edge Driver Creator, Xiaomi, Aquera, Tuya, and Zeus Edge Drivers. And finally, at the very bottom of the Edge Driver resource list, I have included a link to a SmartThings community article titled, How to Post Requests for Edge Drivers. This will be useful if you have a device that is not found within the resources I have provided in today's episode. I encourage you to go to the SmartThings community, the link is below, and ask the community for guidance. I have found community members to be very responsive and helpful. I am certain that you can appreciate the value of these information and resource links. That being true, please give this video a like. Also, be sure to subscribe and set notifications to ensure that you receive an email about future updates. Until my next episode, keep automating and God bless.